This lecture is about the questions that are going to test you your understanding upon blood relations. These questions are going to tell you how a few people are linked or related to each other, and then in the end they will ask how one particular person is related to another particular person in that group. Or it could be mixed up and the format can be changed, but the basic remains the same, that you have to identify how a group of people are related to each other. For example, if A is related to B and B is related to C, then how is A related to C? Okay? The way I see it, there are three ways of solving these questions. First, use your mind. Some people like it that they just read the question and in their own understanding, they keep forming links. Okay? So what they'll do is they'll read that A is B's father. Okay? And in their mind, they'll form a picture or they'll form an understanding that A is B's father, B is C's mother. Okay, then there's another link here, B is C's mother. So this is all going on in their head, and in the end, they're going to answer the question. Okay, that is one way of doing it. The other way is use yourself. This is one interesting way. Okay, what you can do is, in your own mind, you place yourself in place of a certain person in the group. For example, if this is the question, A is B's brother, B is C's father, C is D's sister, and how is A related to D? This is asked. Okay? So what you can do here is, you can picture yourself as any one of A, B, C, D. Suppose we think that we are A, then we in our own mind will form B as a brother. So what you have to do here is, think of your own brother. Okay? If you don't have a brother, then think of an imaginary brother, and then form all these links and see where you arrive at. For example, if I am A, B, okay, I'll say my brother, I'll visualize my brother, and then my brother's daughter or son, and then I'll see that this is the daughter that we are talking of, because it's the sister here, so it's a she. B is C's father, then my brother, and C is his daughter, so I imagine my brother's daughter, and then I see that D is either a brother or a sister to my brother's daughter. Okay, so all of this in my mind, I'm just using myself as a person here, and in the end, it's easier for me to understand who that person is in the end, or what the relationship is. And third is use a pen. This is what we normally do. You take up the question, you start writing, A is B's brother, B is C's father, C is B's sister. But then what happens here is, it gets confusing, okay? It's just another way of writing the question. It does not help you solve. So what do we do here? What we do is, we form ways of representing this information in a more pictorial way. Okay, what I do is, I say that when I have spouses, I use the arrow. Okay, if I know that A is B's husband, okay, then I write a male over here, and a female over here. This arrow denotes marriage. A downward arrow denotes motherhood or fatherhood for the person. Okay. So as we can see that this is a female, this is a male. So this person B will be mother of, let's say, C here. Okay. Now C is sister or brother for D. So I use a plus sign here to represent brothers or sisters. And then it becomes easier for me to understand how is A related to D. That is my way of doing it. Okay. You can form your own diagrams, you can form your own schematics, and that will help you to solve these questions. Let's take a look at one sample question and see if we cannot apply these tactics here. Right, so this is the question. It's given that A is B's father. So we'll represent it here. A is B's father. So we know A is a male, right? Now C is E's mother. Okay. So C is E's mother, a female. Okay. E and D are cousins. E and D are cousins. Okay. So we say E and D are cousins. If you have cousins and you want to denote them differently, probably you can use a circle. That is what I do. Okay. So this will denote a cousin. D and B are brothers. Fine. So we have D and B as brothers here. Now we see B is related to A in this way. So why don't we represent it like this? And we can just forget about this one. Now, how is A related to E? Okay. A related to E. We see that D and E are cousins, right? So we see that this is a different family here. Thus, A being a male is an uncle for E. See, E and D are cousins. D is a son or a daughter for A, and thus A becomes an uncle for E. Right? Here we do not know whether A is a paternal or a maternal uncle. This is not clear, but at least this is clear that he is an uncle. So this is how you solve it. Now you could have done it in your own mind. You could have said, fine, I'm going to be A, and then you would have imagined A is B's father, okay. Now it's hard for a lot of us, a lot of our friends who are not married, to imagine certain something like this. So why don't you imagine yourself to be E or B? Let's say we are B, so our father, C is E's mother, fine, not related here. D and B are brothers, so my brother, I have a father here, I remember that. A is my father, D is my brother, D and E are cousins, so E is my cousin. And C is E's mother. So my aunt is C. Fine. How is A related to E? How is my father related to my cousin? So that's how you solve blood relation questions. Practice a lot. Best of luck.